dear children, welcome back to our social class. Today we are going to discuss about our second lesson, that is weather and climate. Children, how is your weather now? In my place, now too sunny. Yesterday morning, too sunny, afternoon cloudy, evening rainy. Night, clear sky. But today morning, partly cloudy, now sunny. Evening, I cannot say. Why? Because weather is changing rapidly. What is happening here? Are you observing my words? Yes, changing of weather rapidly. Weather is changing rapidly. It is not taking much time. Weather is taking short period of time to change. Okay? Now, climate. Climate is what the weather is like over a long period of time in a specific area. It means average weather of a place over a period of many years. So, climate is taking long period to change, or many years also taking to change. Okay, children. This is about weather and climate. Okay, open your textbook, page number 134. Children, this is your second lesson, weather and climate.
Weather. At a given place and at a particular time, the degree of temperature, wind, amount of humidity in the air and rainfall determine the weather. Weather is the condition prevailing for a short period of time over a small area. We may experience different weather conditions during the same day. Why? Because weather changes constantly. The overall changes in weather conditions that sustain for a long period make seasons. The weather of a place can change rapidly. It may be bright and sunny with a clear sky in the morning, while in the evening sky may be covered with dark clouds. It may start raining in the morning, but the afternoon may be bright and sunny. These are the changes. Weather can change within a few minutes or hours. Weather change hour to hour, minute to minute, day to day, place to place. Okay, children, this is about weather. Now, climate. Climate is the average of weather conditions for a long period of time across a large area. Different types of climate are experienced in different parts of the world. The climate of a place influences the lifestyle of people, crops grown, clothes worn, food eaten, and houses built. The climate also affects the life of animals and plants found in a region. Affects the life of animals and plants found in a region. See, children, factors that determine climate. Distance from the equator. See, children, the sun has a major influence on the climate of place. The area along the equator gets direct heat from the vertical rays of the sun and is thus hotter than the other latitudes. See here, this is model of the earth and this is sun. See here, vertical rays, these are direct rays of the sun. Direct rays. So here, sun is giving too hot. Direct rays, this area takes direct rays of the sun. So so here very hot, and slanting rays of the sun, these areas taking slanting rays of the sun, so here area, this area is not too hot, but it hot and humid. Okay children, see down in this area, frigid zone. This is frigid zone, and here also frigid zone. Here slanting, steep slanting sun rays are coming here, so this area cool throughout the year. Cool, why? Because sun rays are coming very steep and slanting rays. Okay, see here another point is, as we move away from the equator, rays of the sun become slanting. This makes the climate less hot. Slanting rays makes the climate less hot. See, height above the sea level. The height of a place above the sea level is called the altitude of that place. The higher we go, the cooler it gets. If we go higher from the sea, the cooler weather is cool. Places located at higher altitudes are cooler than places located at lower altitudes. Places located at higher altitudes are cooler than places located at lower altitudes. For example, see Bengaluru and Chennai. These are the main cities in our India. These are almost on the same latitude, but Bengaluru is much cooler than Chennai. See, observe these children. Bengaluru and Chennai are almost same latitude, but Bengaluru is much cooler than Chennai. Why? Because it is about 3100 feet above the sea level. Bengaluru is about 3100 feet above the sea level. That is why Bengaluru is cool about Chennai. While Chennai is located almost at the sea level. That is why Chennai is getting hot. Why? Because it is almost at the sea level. Bengaluru and Chennai are almost on the same latitude, but Bengaluru is much cooler than Chennai because Bengaluru is about 3100 above the sea level, while Chennai is located almost the sea level. That is the difference between these two big cities in our India. Now, distance from the sea. Distance. Places closer to the sea are neither very hot nor very cold. Near the sea places are very hot or nor very cold. Whereas places far away from the sea have extreme climates. Far away means long distance places are extreme climates. For example, Delhi is very cold in winter and very hot in summer. Why? Because it is far away from the sea coast. Delhi is far away from the sea coast. In summer, the breeze from the sea cools the hot air on the land, while in the winter, the warm breeze come from the sea prevents the air on the land from getting cold. Sea breeze is warm because water cools down slowly. See children, sea breeze is warm. Sea breeze means wind. Sea breeze is warm because water cools down slowly. That is the reason. That is why Mumbai also one of the big city in our India. This is located near the Arabian Sea. So, Mumbai, which is near the Arabian Sea, experiences moderate temperature throughout the year. See children, direction of the winds. See, cool direction of the winds. Winds influence the weather of a place depends on the places of their origin. The winds coming from cold region decrease the temperature of the region, whereas the winds coming from the hot regions increase the temperature of the region. The winds coming from the sea make the region humid. Humid, do you know the meaning of humid? Now we are going to discuss about humid. Humidity. The amount of moisture or water vapor in the air is called humidity. The amount of moisture or water vapor in the air is called humidity. It affects the climate of place. Winds blowing from the sea have a lot of moisture in them. That is why places near the sea such as Mumbai and Chennai are very humid. The rainfall that a place receives also depends on the level of humidity in the air. Now, see this picture, children. Heat zones of the earth. Heat zones of the earth. Based on the intensity of the heat received by a particular place, the earth can be divided into three heat or temperate zones. Here, heat zones are divided into three types. One is torrid zone, temperate zone, freezing zone. See here, torrid zone or tropical zone, temperate zone and freezing zone. Shall we discuss about these? See, look at this picture, children. Now we are going to talk about torrid zone. This is model of the earth. This is equator line. This is equator line. And this line, Tropic of Cancer. And this is Tropic of Capricorn. This is Antarctic Circle. This is Arctic Circle. See children, now we are going to talk about torrid zone. This zone receives direct rays of the sun. The area which lies on both the sides of the equator between the Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn is called torrid zone. In this zone, climate remains hot and humid throughout the year. This is about torrid zone. Now, north temperate zone, south temperate zone. Now we are going to discuss about temperate zone. This zone receives slanting rays of the sun. This zone receives slanting rays of the sun. The area which lies between the torrid zone, and freezing zone. In both the hemispheres is called temperate zone. This zone receives slanting rays of the sun. The area which lies between the torrid zone and the freezing zone in both the hemispheres is called the temperate zone. This area is neither very hot nor very cold. This is about temperate zone. Now, freezing zone. This zone receives steep and slanting rays of the sun. The area which lies between the Arctic Circle and the North Pole in the Northern Hemisphere is called North Frigid Zone. The area which lies between the Arctic Circle and the North Pole in the Northern Hemisphere is called North Frigid Zone. This is South Frigid Zone. The area that lies between the Antarctic Circle and the South Pole in the Southern Hemisphere is called the South Frigid Zone. The Frigid Zone is extremely cold throughout the year. The Frigid Zone extremely cold throughout the year. Okay, children, this is about heat zones. This is about heat zones. Heat zones are divided into three types. One is torrid zone or tropical zone. Another one is temperate zone. Last one is frigid zone. We discussed already. Okay, children. Read well, prepare well, my dear children. Now, today's homework is, these are the important points of our lesson. You have to prepare all these important points, children. Read and write one time in your social notes. Next class, I will explain about, let us practice grammar part. Okay, children? Let us meet again in the next class. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you, my dear children. Thank you.